Good afternoon, Shamrock fans, and good day, maids. As today's game, we begin on a rainy but warm Sunday afternoon. However, those of you listening on Australia, it's most likely Monday morning, and those of you listening are probably in school. Today we have an international game between our Shamrocks and the Aussie Basketball Travelers. My name is Anthony Pasquale, and this is Nathan Uzenis, and we begin by talking about Friday's victory. Wow.
Yeah, Pat's really put on a great performance. Everything was clicking, especially on defense. Stopped them much. They had a lot of height on us, but it wasn't much of an advantage for them because we really stopped them, especially in the post. Today we got another difficult performance against this Aussie Basketball Travelers team.
Yeah, they have a lot of height on this team, and they only have one player who is under 6 foot, and he's 5'11". Now I will leave you for the court with a bit of a...
And your St. Patrick Shamrocks. We're going to introduce everybody on the teams. We'll start with the Shamrocks. He wears number 10, Kevon Johnson. Number 11, Jalen Nelson. Number 12, Michael Killian. Number 13, Sean Eck. Number 20, Xavier Pinson. Number 21, Luke Lewis. Number 22, Max Trophy. Number 23, Keisham Thomas. Number 24, Lawrence Merrick. Number 25, Rudy Pacquiao. Number 30, Marcus Wright. Number 31, John Hamilton. Number 32, Ido Ajayi. Number 33, Jack McLaughlin. Number 34, Chris Lara. Number 35, Eric Bliss. Number 41, Henry Duchuan. Scott Mitchell. And Jeremiah Jones. The Shamrocks coaching staff in his 22nd year. He's a Hall of Famer, Mike Bailey. He is assisted by Mike Monroe, Brian Houston, and Dave Graham. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's offer a very nice Shamrock welcome to our friends from Australia. They're from Brisbane and the Sydney. He wears number 0, Auckland Merchant. He wears number 1, Sean Burstow. Number 2, Tom Haynes. Number 6, Minoru Magahi. Number 7, Oliver Anderson. Number 11, Aiden Harris. Number 13, Flynn Nation. Number 15, Harish Jamison. Number 22, Ben Hastings. And number 23, Dylan Gray. The Aussies are coached by Mr. Aaron Harding. He is assisted by Mr. Alex Loud. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our friends from Brisbane, Australia. our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back after a great rendition of the national anthem. Now going through Australia's starting lineup. Number 6, Mitteru McCaughey. Number 23, Dylan Gray. Tom Haynes. Sean Barristow. And Ben Hastings. That's Australia's starting five, and now we send you to the Shamrocks starting five. Jalen Nelson. Number 24, Lights Out Lawrence, Lawrence Merritt. Sean Eck, number 13. Dewey Pecanini. And John Hamilton, that's your St. Patrick Shamrock starting five. Once again, my name is Anthony Pasquale, and this is Nathan Huzenas. We bring you an international contest between the Aussies Basketball Travelers and our St. Patrick Shamrocks. Shamrocks are coming off a great victory where they beat a team full of height, and they have a similar task ahead of them tonight.
Yeah, once again, if we play like we did versus Marist, we should be able to shut them down in the paint and the post. I mean, at the beginning of the game versus Marist, we gave up two easy buckets, but then from there, we pretty much shut them down in the paint, which is surprising considering, I mean, their center had about 6 inches, half a foot on ours. So once again, we're going to see hopefully a similar defense by St. Pat's.
Yeah, once again, this Aussie Basketball Travelers team has all of their players above 6 foot except for one, and that one is their point guard, and he's 5'11", so it should be a tough task for the St. Patrick Shamrocks. As we see the jump, it looks like the 6'8 kid, Hamish Jamison, will be jumping against John Hamilton.
Let's see if Hamilton can get the jump.
And the jump is up. And we're in international action as the Shamrocks take the jump and Shawnak brings it up. Shawnak to Jalen on the outside. Jalen gives it to Lawrence, fakes the shot, gives it to Dewey on the edge. Back on the top of the key to Sean, on the perimeter to Lawrence. Over to Jalen. Jalen in the corner to Sean. He'll have a driving lane. Take it back out and give it to Dewey. Back to Lawrence. Jalen on the perimeter. Jalen to Sean on the back of the top of the key. Now Dewey on the perimeter. Back to Lawrence on top. Sean on the side. Taking it in. He'll have nothing. Give it to Dewey to Lawrence. Lights out Lawrence for three. Missed it. And Shawnak will be unable to grab the board as the Aussie Basketball Travelers will retain possession. A lot of passes that possession.
Yeah, that was a long possession by the St. Pat's, but we didn't. I don't think they got the shot they were looking for. Kind of a bailout three right there.
Yeah, I agree. As the Aussie's looking for something, and this will be the Shamrocks in man-to-man defense. And Dewey will take it, and he'll be dribbling down the court. Fast break opportunity, stops for the floater, no good. And the Shamrocks retain possession as Aussie was the last one to touch it.
Yeah, Dewey kind of stopped his momentum there, pulled up for kind of an ill-advised shot. He could have passed it.
Yeah, it looked like he had Jalen there. Now give it to Dewey on top. Now Sean will take it, kind of slow things down a little bit. Gave it to Jalen on the side. It's good. A three for the SS Jalen, and ladies and gentlemen, the SS stands for sharpshooter.
Nice shot by Jalen.
Dewey unable to get the block down. He'll miss, however. They'll get the rebound back as Lawrence dives on the floor for it. Kind of threw it up, but it went right to him as they pass it around the edge. Behind the back move there. Give it around the edge. Shamrocks now look like they're in a zone.
Yeah, it's the second time in a row, two games in a row, we've seen them switch defenses mid-possession.
And that's a travel. The Shamrocks will get the ball back with a 3-0 lead here with about 6 minutes left in the first quarter. Dewey to Sean. Sean's been around for, I think, 3 or 4 years on varsity. He really looks poised, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's going to be one of the leaders of this St. Patrick basketball team, for sure.
There's Lawrence on the edge, back to Jalen on top. Jalen to Sean. Sean to Dewey. Dewey's got Jalen. Jalen gives a couple of fakes, gives it to Lawrence. Sean on the perimeter. John Hamilton in the corner. There's Jalen to lights out Lawrence. To John in the corner. Gives it to Lawrence. He'll slow things down a bit. Finds Dewey on top to Sean to Jalen. Jalen will take another three. It's in! SS Jalen does it again. Sharp shooter.
Yeah, St. Pat's facing a similar defense as they did in Marist. Once again, Australia's playing 2-3 zone defense, and they beat him again with a three.
Now call Lawrence there for a foul. I think one big difference between this team and the team of last year is last year, obviously, they had Nick Coleman, such a great shooter, but he was one of their only shooters. The rest of the offense was generated inside the paint. This year, they have a lot of shooters.
Yeah, I mean, in the starting five, I mean, four of those guys can shoot, pretty much shoot. I don't know if Jaham has a long-range shot, but I bet if he put one up, he could probably make it.
And there's Keyshawn checking in for Lawrence.
And good perimeter shooting is a big key to beat the 2-3 zone.
Mm-hmm. I know one of the big college basketball teams that plays the zone is Syracuse, and the only times they get beat is when the other team has a great shot.
Yeah, that's probably why we've been seeing a lot of passing by St. Pat so far, try to get the perimeter shots open.
I agree. And their three is no good. Shamrock still have the shutout intact. And there's Sean. He'll have it on a fast break. Sean gives a pass to John. John will take the layup and get fouled. He'll be going to the line for two. I feel like after every whistle, John Hamilton's on the ground.
Yeah, he's a hustle player right there. That's kind of interesting. We saw kind of a height disadvantage for Australia. They had all those guys in the paint, but they kind of just tipped it back, and there was three or four guys in the paint trying to rebound. Just no one was there to get back. They had to call a foul.
That high-arcing shot by Jonathan Hamilton. He made one yesterday off the backboard. That one just swishes right in.
Yeah, it looked good.
The lineup is now John, Dewey, Sean, Jalen, and Keyshawn. And John's second is no good. As Austin's going to try to bring it up fast. Dewey tries to poke it out from behind, unable to. Shamrocks look like they're back in a 2-3 defense. And Aussie will be no good on the three. Shawnak will take it up. Shamrock's up 7-0 here with 4 minutes left. There's Keyshawn on the side to Sean. Sean backs it out, trying to call an offense there.
Yeah, Sean takes it.
Sean takes it to Keyshawn. Keyshawn dribbles it around, finds Jalen on the perimeter. Jalen dribbles through the paint, back out, gives it to Sean. Sean's not one of those guys who likes to shoot a lot. We've seen that.
Nah, he likes to pass and make his teammates better.
And Keyshawn for the three. He's good as well. Dynamite from the outside.
Yeah, this 2-3 zone is getting burnt from the outside. And like we said, it's just a lot of passing breaks it down.
That's a 10-point lead now. And as you see, the sophomores previously won by, I believe, 25. I believe the score was 60-35. They had a really good game.
Yeah, once again, St. Patrick for the sweep.
Yeah, it's the freshman one as well. And here comes Xavier Pinsent, the sophomore, checking into the varsity game against Australia. He put on one heck of a show in the sophomore game.
Yeah, he was shooting great from outside. He looked really good. Hopefully he's not tired from the last game, though.
He had one excellent behind-the-back pass that, unfortunately, we couldn't catch on camera because it was a sophomore game. But it was one of those plays where he used his vision, picked up the ball, and just flicked it right behind his back for an easy bucket.
Yeah, even though you guys didn't see the sophomore game, it just looked like we had way more athleticism. We had a pressure defense. We just had so many steals in that game.
Yeah. Now you see our wonderful cheer squad putting on another performance there. In the first timeout, we like to talk about the three keys to the game. I spoke to Coach Bailey beforehand, and he said the first key is pay attention. They're coming off a big win with an energized stud section. They don't have that here, and they can't take this team lightly. It doesn't look like they did this far, and I believe that if they keep their foot on the gas, there will be no turning back. Second key he said is downcourt pressure.
See what they do on the inbounds.
Io has a little bit of a stitch above his right eyebrow. I wonder what that is all about. And Io grabs the rebound, puts it back up, no good, gets it again, puts it up, no good, but he'll get fouled. Ladies and gentlemen, during another break in the action, we'd like to reiterate our three keys to the game because I believe they were lost because of poor audio thus far. Coach Bailey said that the team needs to pay attention. They came off a big win with an energized stud section. They need to pay attention to what's going on. They have to get down court pressure to neutralize the height of the opposing team. And as every game, they have to get better. As Io misses the first one, I asked Coach Bailey, how do you neutralize height? And he said, in this particular game, they need to keep the pressure up to neutralize the height of the other team. And that way they can create buckets, and they have 10 zip here with only two and a half left in the first quarter.
Yeah, I'd like to see Pat's maybe causing some more turnovers, even though our defense has been really good. So,
and Io gets that free throw to go, 11 zip.
There you go, you see the full court pressure.
With Xavier taking on the point guard behind the back there, gets it over the line. And I think they'll get either Xavier or Dewey for a foul there.
Yeah, probably block and foul off his lane.
It was on number 25. That's Dewey, yeah. Dewey, number 25, his first, team second. And also we'll get the ball in.
Pats back into a man.
Yep, man-to-man defense now. And Xavier will grab the rebound and head right back up court. He's an energizing kid when he plays. Gives it to Lawrence on the corner. Back to Xavier. Xavier to Dewey's wide open for the three. No good. And Austin will get the rebound and head back down court.
Nice job stopping the ball.
And there, Dewey will get the steal. Brings it around Io's back and heads down. There's Lawrence. He'll go for a nice in-and-out move. No good on the basket as Io re-gets it and misses the layup again. Io's missed a few layups in this game. If he converted those, the score would be a lot bigger.
Yeah, although I got to give him the credit for getting those rebounds. Most of those are second-chance rebounds, so It's good to see. I mean, those are going to fall later in the game.
As you see, Aussie looks a little bit fatigued, and I talked to Coach Bailey before the game. He said they might be a little bit fatigued because they played last night.
Yeah, that's kind of a disadvantage for Aussie.
There you have it. With a minute and a half left, Aussie gets his first points of the game as it's 11-2 Shamrocks. Xavier's taking charge. He also looks poised on this varsity team, which is shocking coming from a sophomore who's been playing down on that team for a while.
Yeah, I think he recognizes kind of solid defense. They just played game before, so I mean, the only disadvantage of that is he's kind of tired probably, but he looks really energetic right now, so we'll see if the fatigue plays a role later in the game.
I think we might have found a nickname for Keyshawn Thomas. How about the Bullet?
That's a good one.
Because he really does shoot through the hole in a defense like the Bullet, as you saw there. And he snagged another hoop. It's 13-2 Shamrocks with exactly 1 minute remaining here in the first quarter.
That's one of Keyshawn's best skills, just getting to the basket, creating off a dribble.
Yeah, but I think we can add that to the list of nicknames. Hashtag Bullet for Keyshawn Thomas.
I like the one SS Nelson. It's my favorite so far.
Because he's a sharp shooter, ladies and gentlemen. As we're in the middle of a break into the action, we can talk about next Friday's game. It's a big game, Notre Dame. However, we won't be able to broadcast it because it's at Notre Dame.
Yeah, hope to see everyone out there. It's going to be huge. If we can get that win, that'd be great for the future of the season.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a huge confidence builder.
Looks like Max Trophy has checked in along with Sean Eck, and he'll be met with Jalen, Lawrence, and Io as they try to finish out the first quarter.
Yeah, Max is kind of a hard player to match up on because he can shoot the three and he's a pretty big kid. Nice.
Io gets the steal, gives it right to Lawrence. Lawrence with the layup, it's good. I talked to a kid on the sophomore team. Ooh, and that looks like
Lawrence is hurt.
Lawrence is dinged up after that one.
Yeah, it looked like he took a shot to like the stomach or his face on that layup. I was surprised they didn't call a foul.
He originally gave it a. He tried to protect himself even more by just going around the edge.
Yeah, he's one of the leaders of this team. That'd be really devastating to lose him for any amount of time, especially for Friday.
It's a little bit difficult to see what's bothering him because he's not holding anything particularly.
Oh, no.
There he just grabbed his right hip. Hopefully it's just some sort of contusion that he fell on. Hopefully it's not anything more.
Yeah, hopefully it's not serious.
This crowd is silent.
Yeah. I mean, he's been our best player so far this short season, but I mean, he's on his feet by himself, so that's a good sign.
And he's right up there, right next to trainer Joe. He's a really big impact on how our Shamrocks recover from injuries as fast as they do.
Yeah, that'd be sad to see him go off for any time. This kid loves basketball. He lives for basketball. He's going to go to the locker room.
It doesn't look extremely serious as he walked off under his own power without much assistance. It looked like he just kind of hit the floor really hard.
Yeah, it might be just like a stinger or something.
Because he put the ball up in a very awkward way. And I think the substitute for Lawrence will be Xavier Pinson, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, so that's big that Xavier kind of has experience against facing this team, because now it looks like he's going to have to play a much bigger role in this game.
Oh no, they decided to go with a taller lineup with Io, Max, Sean, Jalen, and Keyshawn. I was talking to a sophomore basketball player about Max before the game, and I said, I didn't realize Max can shoot, and he said that kid is knocked down from anywhere on the floor.
Yeah, that's definitely. He wasn't on the team last year, but I remember seeing him at the gym just shooting up threes. I think that's what he just loves to do, to shoot threes.
Another traveling violation as the Shamrocks will get the ball with 15 seconds left in the quarter as they are up by 13, 15-2.
So far in the early season, it's been like one of the biggest keys is just playing great defense, and 2 points in a quarter, that's really good.
There's Jalen on top to Sean, to Keyshawn on the corner. Fakes it, puts it up, no good as the buzzer runs out. That'll be the end of the first quarter. We head to the second quarter with the Shamrocks leading 15-2. Now you can see our wonderful cheerleading team putting in on another one of their routines.
Yeah, it's nice to see them out here on a Sunday.
Yeah, and there's actually quite a big crowd for considering it's a Sunday afternoon. There's not much of a stud section, but there is quite a lot of students here.
Yeah, bleachers are almost completely full. You don't see much of that yellow from the bleachers. I mean, there's definitely some room, but yeah, it's nice to see that so many people are coming out for on a Sunday. See the St. Pat's basketball team.
Yeah, I think they're really, really excited to see what this team can do.
Yeah, this team's got a lot of potential to go places this year.
Go ahead.
I mean, as we said, this team has a lot of potential to even get down to state. I mean, is this team better than what we had last year? It's good debate. I think they might be.
Talking to a lot of people before the season, a lot of them thought no way. But after watching the game against Marist in the beginning of this game against an international traveling team, it doesn't look that bad.
No. I mean, so far we came out looking like we were in mid-season form, especially on defense. If we can play that caliber of defense, especially against a great Marist team, especially offensively, we're going to be really set for the rest of the season. I mean, offense will come as time goes on, but defense is just hustle.
And we have that.
Getting that energy to go out there every day, every night.
And another traveling by the Aussies. And I'd like to say, if we do end up making a run, if we're going to do any kind of run, we're going to need number 24 back in action.
Yeah, he's really he might be our best player this year. So, yeah, we're going to need him for the future.
He put up 20 points on Friday against Marist, and he handled himself in such a humble way. He was loving the stud section, and I talked to him after the game, and all I told him was great game because he deserved to hear that, and all he told me was thank you, sir.
Yeah, he's a humble guy.
And all the passes get it right to John Hamilton, and we'll get the bucket to go. Jay Ham is good. You know what Jay Ham does? Creates mayhem in the paint.
Yeah, guy's a huge presence in the paint. He's not, I mean, what is he, 6'2"?
Let me check here. John Hamilton is, yeah, 6'2". Good call.
He's not extremely tall, he's just got a big body. Oh, there you go, so you see the size. No one really boxed out number 7 on the rebound. He got the rebound kind of just with his height.
Yeah, Oliver Anderson there is number 7. Made the bucket, and he'll be shooting a free throw. This is the first time the Aussies have been at the line today.
Yeah, I bet Coach Bailey didn't really like that there.
And his free throw is no good, and Sean will grab the rebound, snatch it up, and he'll head down court. Looks like they're in a 3-2 defense.
Yeah, they're trying to trap the top guard. Oh.
Keyshawn fakes it, had us wondering what he was doing with the ball. Dewey with the behind himself pass to Jalen, no good. And that'll be a basket. It'll be 17-6.
Yeah, kind of just let him in there. Put it up, got it in.
Sean's taking control now, calling an offense. Dewey to Sean.
Yeah, they're trying to trap the guard at the top. Usually if you break this down, you can get, yeah, that's what you got to do. You get a perimeter shot from the corner.
And no good.
Keyshawn weaved himself in there. Got a good shot, though.
The bullet did it again. Back on top. Almost lost it there. Now it looks like they're back in man-to-man defense.
Nice steal.
Steal by Keyshawn. The bullet will head right in for an easy left-handed layup. 19-6 now, Shamrocks.
Like Coach Bailey said, just put pressure on the bigs, especially the top of the key.
Got gives a little behind-the-back pass, no good. John Hamilton gets it, and Sean will try to run the floor here. and he'll weave right in, but he'll get it taken away from him as John slides on the floor, pokes it back. There now as they shoot a three, no good air ball there. However, they get the rebound. They left him wide open, and he missed as well.
Yeah, three wasn't really even close.
Two air balls there. Coach Bailey doesn't look happy with that possession. They gave, I think, two or three offensive rebounds and allowed three wide open shots.
Yeah, that's what you can't do. You got to box out, especially that we don't have any height on our team compared to this Australian team. Got to box out. No second chance opportunities.
And Jalen, no good. He'll get his own board, put it right back up, and he's good there. 21-8, Shamrocks.
Great hustle getting his own board right there.
As the Aussies are looking around, get it on the edge. And no good there as John gobbles up the rebound. We'd like to thank Mr. Preslak for checking in. He says, good day, mates. I'm going to make a shrimp on the Barbie if I can make it to the yard. Nice job and go Shamrocks. Thank you for checking in, Mr. Preslak. And thank you for the seniors for checking in. Jimmy O'Donnell, Nate Segura, John Prince, Sean Formal, Julian Cruz, and Sargon Dinka. Thank you all for tuning in. Once again, folks, I am Anthony Pasquale, and this is Nathan Huzenas bringing you an international contest between the Aussie Basketball Travelers and our St. Patrick Shamrocks. Right now, there are 4.5 minutes left in the first half as the Shamrocks are leading 23-8. Henry Goochwan checked in. The Gooch gives it on the edge to Keyshawn. Dribbles around, gives it to Jalen. Threads the needle to Henry. He'll take a jumper, and it's good.
Nice shot.
Henry last year was kind of more of an awkward kind of kid. Didn't really have as much of a post moves as he does now. He really, really followed Duncan White around.
Yeah, I think he understands his role now this year, being the number one or two big man on this team. He understands what he has to do.
It's 25-10 Shamrocks now as Jalen dribbles around to the top of the key, passes to Shawnak on the perimeter, over to Max on top.
And once he gets those post moves, he's going to be a really great player because he's already got that little outside mid-range shot.
Jalen to Max, no good, as the Aussies will retain possession. There's Cramon Johnson, KJ, checking in for Keyshawn.
He's getting his first minutes of the season, I think, right?
Yeah, these are the first minutes that we've seen him play. And last year, Cramon had a pretty good year on the sophomore level.
Yeah, he's definitely a great athleticism for a
big guy. Yeah,
he's a junior, so got a lot of height and length.
Yeah, I think Cramon is one of the taller kids on the team. As Cramon is 6'2".
Yeah, 6'2". Not a lot of strength, but definitely fast, quick. Has great moves off the dribble, too.
He just missed a shot, and the Aussies got the rebound, but they slipped on it and threw it out of bounds, so it'll be our ball.
Nice.
And I believe that is Jalen with the inbound pass. They'll give it to Max on top. Over to Sean. Sean to Jalen.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what Cramon does for this team. He said over the summer that he's working on his three-point shot a lot.
And there's Henry again. Big man with a nice jumper. As Australia's back down the court quickly. They'll be passing it around the edge.
So last possession, they did some kind of play where they screened, double stagger screen down at the bottom of the paint, got an open three.
There's number 15. Hamish Jamison in there. He's 6'8". Looks a little ginger when he moves. As Shawnak ends up on the floor, there'll be a foul called. And it looks like Io, Keyshawn, and Dewey are checking in. And now the lineup will be Io, Keyshawn, Dewey, Sean, and Henry. There's Coach Monroe, sophomore coach, as he coached a great victory as the sophomore team blew out the Aussies.
Yeah, neither the freshman or sophomore game was really close at all.
Yeah.
This game could get out of hand really soon, too. I mean, we're already up 17 points.
Yep, 2.5 left in the first half as the Shamrocks are up 17.
Yeah, so far the Aussie defense has not been that
Sean Cramon inside to Keyshawn to Io. Dewey for three. He's got it. Dewey Pecanini is good.
Once again, that's a way to break that zone. You just bring the ball in, take it out. Once the defense collapses, you get an open perimeter shot.
And that's what the Shamrocks have been capitalizing on early in the season, those open perimeter shots.
Yeah, that's going to kind of be one of the big differences for our team this year. We have a lot of perimeter shooting.
And it looks like Xavier's back in the game for Cramon, kind of a smaller lineup now, as it's Xavier, Keyshawn, Dewey, Sean, and Io. Xavier wears number 20, and on the freshman team, he wears, sophomore team, he wears number 11. He'll generate a steal, get it to Dewey, who's bringing up the court. They'll give it to Xavier. He'll drive right in, smooth handles, and he'll get the ball taken from him, gobbled up by Keyshawn.
Keyshawn just hustled from the other side of the court, got the ball.
Sean dribbles in, gives it to X on the corner. X is good. Couldn't even tell the ball went in. That's how smooth that shot looked.
Yeah, great pass by Sean X. Great vision. Went into the paint, didn't know what he was doing. Passed it, saw Xavier wide open, hit another three.
I've gotten to watch Xavier play basketball for 2 years now, and all I can say, if there's one word to describe it, it's smooth. Everything he does, the way he dribbles the ball, the way he shoots, everything is just smooth.
Yeah, it seems like a great ball player.
I don't know if we can figure out a nickname dealing with the word smooth, but it would definitely deal with X. Now to Keyshawn in the corner. Keyshawn for three. The bullet no good. Is Sean will get the rebound. I believe Sean has taken one or two shots this game. That's it.
Yeah, he's looking for his other teammates. As you saw in that last session, drove in looking for someone on the outside. Knew that defense was going to collapse.
As the Shamrocks have gotten two offensive rebounds, one by Sean and one by Io, to keep this long possession going. I think that possession ate up about 30 to 45 seconds of the clock now, as Iowa will be shooting two.
Yeah, that's one of the nice things about shooting threes. You get those long boards, easier for offensive rebounds, second chance points.
That'll be Hamish Jamison's first, as Iowa will go to the line for his second set of free throws today.
Yeah, Iowa's got, three or four offensive rebounds already?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's really working on that.
And they've all turned into fouls, too, gave him some shots at the free throw line, although he's, I believe, 1 for 3 at the line so far.
Yeah, it's big when you have a great interior presence getting those offensive rebounds, putting the players into foul trouble.
Mm-hmm. And he'll make that one, so he's at a solid 50% from the line as the first half almost comes to a close.
I think that's a foul on Sean Ack.
Yeah, it looks like it. No, it doesn't look like they called a foul. I think it was one of those where players got tangled up.
Oh, okay.
45 seconds remain here in the second half as the Shamrocks lead by 22.
Kind of a late whistle there.
Yeah, kind of a nonchalant whistle as well. That'll be the Shamrocks' fourth foul and the second on Dewey.
Oh, they call that on Dewey? Okay.
And there goes Jalen Nelson checking in. The SS Nelson coming on into the game. Nate, can you do me a favor when you go down during halftime, try to get some buzz on Lawrence, see how he's doing.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Try to figure out if there's a return table for the game.
I mean, at this point, you kind of don't really want to see him come back too early, especially in a game that we're kind of up by a lot. So.
His X will get a steal and drive right in, misses the left-handed layup. His Keyshawn will miss putback attempt, but he'll get it back after the tip by Io. To X in the corner, dribbles in, and they're going to call a blocking foul, as it'll be Shamrock ball.
Well, I like that play by Xavier on that fast break, just took an aggressive play to the basket, got a good shot, just missed it.
If there's one thing I think that kid has to work on, it's probably left-handed layups.
Yeah, he's a dominant right-handed player, right?
Mm-hmm. And Sean gets it on the inbound pass, throws it all the way across to Xavier. Xavier dribbles smoothly. There's 3 seconds left to Io on the perimeter. No good. That'll be the end of the first half, ladies and gentlemen, as the Shamrocks are up by 22, 34-12 after first half of basketball, international basketball, as the Shamrocks lead the Aussies 34-12. In a few minutes, I will be joined by Coach O'Connor here, Director of Admissions here. But for the meantime, just hang tight. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here with a halftime interview of graduate of 2005, Coach O.C. How you doing, Coach?
I'm doing well. How you doing today?
I'm good.
Cooperative for December in Chicago, so I'm sure they're very pleased that there's no snow on the ground.
Do you know how they got to get an Australian team to come here to play?
I'm not entirely sure how this worked out. My understanding is they set up a tour here and played last night at Geneva High School, and obviously they wanted to play more than one basketball game in Chicago, and we have a relationship with Geneva, so I think it worked out nicely for them coming into the city today.
So, Coach, you did a great job getting all those shadows here Friday night for the Marist game. What do you think's in store for the incoming class?
It's going to be a great group. We're really excited here at St. Pat's for the future Shamrocks to come in, the class of 2020. This year, just the buzz, the atmosphere around St. Pat's has been really positive. Not that last year wasn't, but the work of the admissions team at St. Pat's, myself, Matt O'Brien, Mike Fabrizio, Coach Galante, Coach Bailey has been awesome. And we're expecting about 300 boys here to test on January 9th, so we're really excited.
So, you just said your job kind of entails with recruiting a lot of people. What do you like about the job?
I just love, as a graduate of St. Pat's, seeing young men in grade school, you know, that were just like me. And it's exciting because I know what's in store for them here, and I can sell the benefits of St. Pat's because it's such a great place. I think it's a very unique high school. The all-boy environment, the competitiveness here, just the great sense of family and brotherhood that we feel as Shamrocks is special, and to tell families and young men about that is awesome, and I'm glad I get to do that every day.
So what is it about the school that makes you keep, that made you come back and stay here?
I mean, I did a couple jobs after college, graduated from U of I, and you know, worked in corporate America, and I never felt that sense of connection, like I was really doing much besides collecting a paycheck, and always wanted to coach and just be involved and have a positive impact. And I feel that, you know, like I said, what the product here that comes out of St. Pat's is spectacular, and this is my home. If I could do it over again, I'd rather go back to St. Pat's than anything else.
So obviously this team is from Australia, so it's an international game. What do you think that means for St. Pat's that they're playing an international team?
I'd love to do this every year. I mean, I can't speak for the basketball program, but the fact that we're, you know, exposing St. Pat's to you know, families and students in Australia is really cool. You know, and it's a unique experience for our guys. I know our guys, I could speak for them because I think it would be pretty awesome, but I'd love to go to Australia and play a basketball game there too.
That would be fun as well. So obviously, a big thing that we talk about is brotherhood and Shamrock pride, and you see behind us it says Shamrock integrity. What does all that mean to you?
You know, you come to St. Pat's, and guys come from all over the city of Chicago, some of the suburbs, all different backgrounds, you know, family makeups. It's you know, kind of a real-world experience here, and the great thing is everybody comes together and puts aside any differences they may have and really focus on getting the best education possible and looking out for each other. That brotherhood, that sense of family is really powerful, and, you know, when you leave here, our goal is to teach the next crop of great, successful guys that there's more than just themselves. That to look out for others first, and then worry about yourself second, and that's the integrity part of St. Pat's.
And I would say since the school's been going for over 150 years,
155 this year,
it's whatever that it is that you guys are doing, you're doing something right. My last question is, what's your favorite moment of all your time here at St. Pat's?
Oh, man, that's a tough question. A lot of great moments. My senior year football team was, you know, a great team, 8-1 in the regular season. Unfortunately, we lost. Had some great basketball games in this gym. Versus Notre Dame High School versus Holy Cross. I can't really pick one. I would say my favorite part of being a student here is my friends. Still, my best friends from St. Pat's are my best friends in my life today, and you know, I know that holds true for a lot of guys.
All right, thank you for joining us, Coach.
Thanks for having me.
Have a good holiday season.
Let's hope the Shamrocks keep it up here in the second half.
Yep, definitely. And we'll be back here right after a short little break for the second half of action. Thank you.
Yeah, and both Jalen and Keyshawn.
stand by calls to start the third quarter.
Time. We're back for halftime, and we have great news about Lawrence Merritt. You can fill him in, Nathan.
Yeah, it looks like he just has a bruised hip. It doesn't look like he's going to come back today, but Coach Sergio said he'd be fine for Friday, so that's really great news.
And after the first half of action, we have an update on the scores. Keyshawn is leading the way with 9, followed by Jalen with 8. As the second half begins, Sean, Jalen, Keyshawn, John, and Dewey. John Hamilton in the corner on top. And it'll go out of bounds. Shamrock ball. Dewey looks like he'll go over there to inbound it. Just like to give a thank you to Coach O'Connor. He does such a great job getting kids to come to our school. I'd like to thank him for the interview.
Yeah, it's been great. St. Pat's getting great numbers for all the new classes, especially freshmen.
There's Dewey over to Keyshawn. Back to Dewey. He's got Sean on the perimeter. Over to Dewey on top.
Australia is still doing that trap thing at the top.
And what an excellent break of the zone as they get it to Keyshawn on the edge, inside to Jalen. Bounce pass to Jay Ham, who causes mayhem in the paint, and he'll get it in.
Yeah, Jay Ham saw that there was no one really covering the middle of that paint. Keyshawn found him.
It was a great cut, too.
Yeah.
As the Shamrocks now lead by 24, 36-12 with 6 minutes left.
St. Pat starts with that man again.
And the Aussies will get a bucket, 36-14 now.
Still a contested shot, still good defense for Pats.
As Dewey will bring the ball up, give it to Sean to take it across. Sean backs up, looks for something. Sharp pass to Keyshawn on the edge, fakes the shot over to Jalen. To Sean, John Hamilton will take a jumper, no good. And the offensive rebound is no good as well. As the Aussies will take it back. I'd like to take some time to add a couple of seniors who tuned in. Nick Sackos, Trevor Heinlein, Daniel Torres, Michael Espinera, Jesus Trejo, Tobin Jacob, Christian Juarez, Kevin Cush, and Alejandro Ventura. And Sean will get the ball and fire it down to Keyshawn, who'll get it to go.
Great defense by Keyshawn. Second time he's had that block steal. And drove it up for an easy layup on each side, both left-handed layups.
That'll be 11 points now for Keyshawn, who's having a really great game.
Yeah.
Sean almost got the steal as it went through his legs.
You can tell Pats is really, one of the keys of the game for Coach Bailey was to pressure the ball. That's exactly what we're doing. We've seen a bunch of turnovers for the Australians.
That last shot was swatted by John as Keyshawn will try to give the pass. Gets tipped, gives it to John, then Sean. Sean takes it back out and slows it down as you see Henry at the scorer's table looking to check in. As Sean will get it picked from his pocket. And Dewey will strip it away. What a great play by Dewey to prevent the basket.
Great defense.
As the Aussies will get the ball and Henry will come in for John. So it'll be Henry, Jalen, Keyshawn, Dewey, and Sean Eck. As the Shamrocks look like they're going into a 2-3 defense now. And that was a little interesting play by the Aussies. Sean had his back turned to him, so they bounced it off of him, and they got it back.
Yeah, Sean did not look happy after that. He looked kind of mad.
He looked very confused about what just happened to him. Looks like he's turning around again. Let's see if they go off his back. Instead, they'll give it to the top of the key. Over to the side. Over on the perimeter. Sean Eck, good defense there. Looks like, yeah, they're back in the 2-3 zone to try to confuse them.
Yeah, Australia doesn't really know. Doesn't look like they know what they're doing on offense. Just kind of a lot of standing around, just making passes on the perimeter.
Good shot fake, and the rebound will be tapped out by Sean Eck as the Aussies will get the ball back.
Yeah, it looks great that
all the guards are getting out to the three-point shooters. They have gotten nothing on the three-point line. I haven't seen them. I don't think they've made a single three-point shot, in fact.
Yeah, they've taken about three or four and missed them all. Another shout-out goes to Dan Chivonik for tuning in. Thank you very much. As the Aussies are looking for to generate some offense. Into the corner. Background gets it swatted away by Dewey, but it'll go right out of bounds.
It almost seems as Pat's defense knows exactly what Australia is doing.
Mm-hmm.
Seems like they're moving before they even see the screens coming.
There's a freshman in the game. Marcus Wright checks in wearing number 30. That's good to see. Shows we have some young promising talent in our smaller teams. As Marcus, a freshman, just checked into the game.
Yeah, Marcus has a lot of potential to be a great player for this team. I think their team, he played for Beasley in grade school.
Mm-hmm.
Team's a great, I think they were in the state championship for eighth graders.
He starts on sophomore regularly, and he put together a great game. I believe double-digit points and almost double-digit assists for the sophomores.
Yeah, he also had a lot of steals that game.
And he'll take his first shot varsity, and he'll be unable to make it, excuse me.
Marcus Wright, also an outstanding baseball player, on side note.
Mm-hmm. Sean Eck threads right in, no good, and he'll get a chance at the line, two shots.
Nice drive by Sean Eck.
Yeah.
Impressive.
He usually plays more of a passive game style where he passes a lot and tries to give opportunities to his fellow teammates, but that time he drove right in.
Yeah, I think that's one of the great things about Sean Eck. He knows when to turn it on and be aggressive, but he also knows when he should be making plays for his teammates.
And that's good. Here you see, no changes, excuse me. They will remain with the same lineup. Marcus, Keyshawn, Sean, Henry, and Dewey. All three seniors are in right now, which is a big difference between the sectional winning team of last year. They had, I believe, eight or nine.
Yeah, last year we had a lot of experience. So that's why I think it was kind of like, oh, we're going to be a lot worse this year because we're losing a lot of the players. But instead, I think a lot of these sophomores who were sophomores last year who are now juniors are going to be able to step up and fill those voids.
Such as Lawrence and Jalen and Keyshawn, to name a couple.
Yeah, we've already seen Keyshawn and Jalen especially step up and been really great this year.
And Lawrence Friday had one heck of a game as well.
Yeah, definitely probably the best game of St. Pat's career.
And they're back with the man-to-man defense. As they'll make a three, it'll be 40-19.
Still, it was a contested three. Still shows that the Pat's defense is still suffocating them from the line.
Definitely.
The three-point line.
There's Keyshawn on the edge in the corner. Dribbles around, kind of getting trapped. Lobs it up. Not a really good pass as Australia will head right back down. Miss the layup, and Dewey will get the rebound. Give it to Sean Eck, who will have nothing but one guy to beat. Nice move, but he missed the layup. And he'll go right back for Australia. What a snag by Dewey. Looked like Odell Beckham out there. Gives the pass to Henry. He can't grab it. Gives it to Keyshawn, and they'll calm things down a bit.
Yeah, two possessions ago, Keyshawn kind of got stuck in the corner, trapped him, and he had to make a bad bailout pass, got stolen.
Looks like a couple of other kids will be checking in to have their first minutes of 2015 season. I see Jack McLaughlin over there, and Max Chofi looks like he's coming back in. I believe that was Marcus making a shot.
So that's his first points of his varsity career.
A three-point field goal for Marcus as the Shamrocks lead 43-19. With a minute and a half remaining here in the third quarter. Over in the corner, same kid shooting another three, no good. Rebound. Offensive, got the ball back. That was Midaru McCaughey that got fouled there. Excuse me if back home in Australia I'm pronouncing that name wrong.
Yeah, it's been one of the keys, Coach Bailey said, box out, get rebounds, and The height for Australia has not been so much of an advantage this game.
Yeah, that pressure that he was talking about is really canceling out the height that we've mentioned earlier.
Yeah, I mean, they've had only a few really productive offensive rebounds.
So here comes Max, Jack McLaughlin, and Xavier Pinson, and out goes Marcus, Shawnack, and I believe Dewey, as Jalen will stay in. Shot is up, and no good. Henry will get the rebound, gives it to Xavier. Have to make something happen. Gives it to Henry in the middle. He'll find Jack down low, gives the pass to Max. Max will get fouled and get the bucket.
Yeah, that's
no basket they just called.
Still, that was great job getting it up the court. That was the first time we've seen that full court pressure from Australia. Got it up with ease.
Yeah, they were able to beat the press and get an easy shot. Unfortunately, it didn't count.
Coach Bailey must have really liked that. Saw two passes. I don't think we even saw the ball on the ground there. Great passing.
Now it looks like Australia is playing a 2-3 zone instead of that 3-2 we saw earlier. As Xavier's taking his time on the top of the key. He's a really good passer, really good ball handler.
Yeah, he's got great vision for the court.
As Max will take the ball to the rack with a guy on his back, but unfortunately won't be able to get it to go. Dylan Gray is definitely their shooter. He's taken, I think, 4 on their last 6 possessions, and I think only made 2.
Yeah, they're all corner threes he's taken.
There's Jalen. Jalen wears number 11. Gives it to Xavier. To Jack on top. This is his first time we've seen him play. He wears number 33.
Wonder if Pat's going to try to get the last shot this quarter.
Is there 18 seconds remaining? Quarter of a minute left as a timeout will be called.
I think they're going to call a foul in the middle, kind of pushed off Jack.
Oh, you're right. You're right. A foul there by...
I think that's number 12.
Number 12. That'll be Australia's 4th foul. That one on number 22, Ben Hastings.
My bad.
Jalen with the pass fake gets it stolen right back to Max. Max in the corner to Jack with 10 seconds remaining in the quarter. He'll give it to Jalen. Jalen takes a wide open 3. Ladies and gentlemen, hop on the SS Jalen Nelson at the end of the 3rd quarter. I'd like to inform you that the SS stands for sharpshooter, as Jalen now has 11 points to match Keyshawn's 11 points. And we'll head to the 4th quarter with the Shamrocks having almost nearly a 30-point lead as they lead 46-19 at the end of the 3rd. Like to focus on some of the keys from Coach Bailey and how well that they're executing. The pressure that we mentioned is huge right now. They're canceling out the height almost completely. And it does look like they're getting better. They're gelling. I think after this game, they'll be at a great spot to head forward into a tough game against a higher ranked Notre Dame.
Yeah, defense has been great. And the offense seems to be getting better and better as the game goes on, which is something we're going to be kind of looking at as the season goes on. How much better can this offense get? There's been a lot of perimeter shots for us so far this season, but if we can start getting stuff in the post and from there on, our offense is really going to be dangerous, especially in our conference. One thing we haven't really been talking about, one of our Bulls players, Cameron Bairstow, his brother's actually on the Australian team. Sean Bairstow.
He wears number 1. He's a guard, and he's 6'2", which is tall the way I look at someone 6'2", but compared to his brother, he's a midget.
Yeah, he's probably pretty jealous. His brother's 6'9".
Yeah.
Probably wants those jeans.
And I'm sure he still has some growing ahead of him, as Cameron has, I think, 4 or 5 brothers or siblings, and one of them is Sean here on the Australian team.
Yeah, Cameron doesn't get to see a lot of the floor for the Bulls, but still in the NBA.
There you see him, number 1. Kind of a same build, similar build as his brother, as Xavier's guarding him. And that'll be out of bounds off the Australian team as the Shamrocks will get possession back. And it looks like Xavier's going to be bringing the ball up. He's joined on the court by Max, Io, I believe that's Jalen, and Keyshawn. Michael Killian checked into the game. His first minutes of the 2015 season as well.
Yeah, it's nice to see that since we're kind of blowing them out, we see the substitutions starting to come in.
There's Mike. There's Jalen with the steal. Nice little dribble. And he stepped out of bounds. They didn't call it. He turned it over anyway. As Max with an excellent excellent defensive board. He'll dribble the ball up himself. Looks like a point guard out there as he gives it on the side to Io.
Yeah, he's got an odd set of skills for his size.
There's Xavier. Gave a little thread pass, but out of bounds as Australia will retake possession. That's the kind of moves that he brings to the table. He's swift and he's smooth with everything he does. It's just sometimes almost it's too unexpected by some of the other players, and it does sometimes lead to some turnovers.
Yeah, he was just trying to create something. He actually had, I think that was Max and right on the low block.
Mm-hmm.
Could have gotten that easy layup. I think just trying to test out some new things since we're kind of, we're up 30, so.
That'll be Sean Barristow coming right through. They'll call a foul there on number 10, I believe. Or excuse me, 20, and that's Xavier Pinson, I think. Yes, Xavier Pinson with his foul. The basket is no good.
That's what we kind of thought, Xavier being in a lot of the game because of Lawrence's injury.
And he's been in here a lot.
Maybe that's one of the reasons Mike Killian's in, also another guard to bring in, fill that spot for Lawrence.
And I can guarantee you if this was like the Notre Dame game, Lawrence would be back in there. But since it's a game where they're blowing them out and they don't necessarily need him at the moment, I think it's a smarter decision to keep him down.
Yeah, if this was a bigger game, definitely Lawrence would be in there right now.
This game is now going back and forth as the Shamrocks have a 27-point lead. And Australia just had a quick basket as Jalen has it on top. Drives right through to the corner. Max Chofi for three, no good. Io will get the rebound and give it to Xavier on top.
Yeah, Io's been doing great on the boards. Another offensive rebound.
He must be close to double digit with just offensive rebounds.
Yeah.
There's Xavier on top, showing off his handles.
Yeah, Australia really hasn't played to their strengths. Their main strength should have been getting rebounds, but Io's really negated that, getting his own offensive rebounds sometimes.
Barristow's brother with another great play as he's trailing now. As Io will be right in the paint. Little in and out move, little spin, got it to go as the Shamrocks are now up by 29, excuse me.
I think that's Io's 6 point.
I believe he has 6 points now.
So, I mean, he could be looking at a double-double after today's game.
Yeah. You got to think he's definitely over 10 rebounds by now.
By now, yeah, for sure. Especially, we haven't really seen him that much in the game, so, I mean, it's pretty impressive how he's already gotten that many rebounds. Shows his impact on the game.
The only other player that I believe has played internationally on our team is Io.
Yeah.
As he was born in, I believe, Nigeria, moved to the UK, then to Canada, and now he's here in Chicago.
Yeah, he's probably got a lot of life experience from all those moving around the world, really.
Mm-hmm. And when you look at the grade schools here on the bulletin, since Iowa's been to so many, all it says is Canada next to his name. As he'll be in there, I believe, along with Marcus Cramon, and that's all I can see at the moment.
There's Coach Luke making his
presence felt. Coach Luke was my halftime interview in the Marist game, and he's such a funny guy, such a pleasure to be around.
Yeah, everyone loves him around the school. Such a great guy. We're lucky to have him here.
Yeah, he's such a great dean, former police officer. There you see Marcus, the freshman in, along with Mike Killian, Jack, Io, and I think that's Jalen. Or Cramon, excuse me. Cramon almost got the steal there.
Yeah, it'd be kind of interesting. Cramon's kind of a wild card. He's got so much potential to be so great. I think he was suspended academically at the beginning of the season, so I think he just has to have time to get involved in this offense, understand what's going on.
Yeah. And not to mention that there's an extreme sophomore talent who's sidelined for the whole year with a torn ACL. His name is Jeremiah Jones. He's about 6'6 or 6'7, and he's a really, really developed post player.
Yeah, Pats is going to be good for a long time. We have a lot of talent, not even this year, but in the future, too.
Mm-hmm. I believe the leading scorers now is Jalen and Keyshawn, both with 11. And now the defense is Cramon, Io, Marcus, Mike Killian, and Jack McLaughlin, as they are now in a 2-3 zone, switched just from man a couple of minutes ago.
Yeah, that's what makes Coach Bailey such a great coach. He sees what Australia is doing and switching defenses based off what they're doing on offense. Kind of like a game of chess, just countering every move that Australia's had.
There you see Jack on the floor, unable to get the ball, as Australia's back on the top of the key, dribbling around towards the right wing on the perimeter. And he can't find anything. Io jumps for the pass, no good, and they'll get the basket to go. Shamrocks lead now by 27, 50-23, as that's Marcus, the freshman, showing extremely calmness playing on a varsity team.
Yeah, definitely. He's probably played in a lot of big games, especially playing at Beasley for his grade school. So
That team would beat a lot of high school teams, I think.
Yeah, that team has a lot of talent. I know a lot of his teammates went to Simeon for basketball. Mm-hmm. Extreme talents there.
I believe that's where both Jabari Parker and Derrick Rose, NBA stars, went to school.
Yeah. Maybe he even had some NBA talent on his team.
Mm-hmm. There's Cramon. He'll get called for the backcourt violation, as he caught it just on the line, and his momentum carried himself over.
Yeah, I think if he would have just started dribbling, he could have sold it. It seemed like kind of a late whistle.
Mm-hmm. As the Aussies are dribbling around. Those of you in Australia, if any of you are listening, we'd like to advertise our school. You could email us at sphswebcast@stpatrick.org or tweet us at Twitter at sphswebcast. And if any of you are listening on Australia, it must not be the greatest to be in school right now.
Yeah, Australia's pretty much getting dominated. They can't get anything on offense, and defense pretty much been lit up from three-point line.
Mm-hmm. And Australia, I believe, is 17 hours ahead of us, so anybody listening now in Australia, I think it's 9 in the morning.
Yeah, sorry to wake up to such a depressing mood, probably.
As the Shamrocks now lead by 27, with about three to go here in the fourth.
Looks like another sophomore checked in, I think. Who's that, number 34?
Number 34 is Chris Lara. He is a sophomore. And they'll call a charge there. The basket will now count. Great play there by Mataroa Magahi. That was one of those plays that a coach would love, especially being down 27, to dedicate his body to the game.
Yeah, kind of a bang-bang play. Could have gone either way. Could have called it defensive.
Mm-hmm.
Could have called blocking.
And he'll dribble right in there.
Wow, they really broke down that defense.
Mm-hmm.
That was easy.
And it's 50-25. We have double the points of the Aussies now. There to Jack. Jack McLaughlin bounces it off number 23, Dylan Gray, as it'll be Shamrock ball.
You kind of tell that the more experience and kind of talent level of Lawrence and Keyshawn easily were able to get out of that trap, but it seemed like Jack had some trouble there.
Yeah, the ball goes to Chris Lara, the sophomore, back to Marcus, freshman, over on the edge to Jack McLaughlin.
Yeah, Jack's having trouble getting out of that trap right there.
In the corner to Killian. Killian puts up the rebound, or the shot, no good. The rebound by Marcus Wright, no good. Io
with another snags board.
The rebound, and he'll get fouled. He'll be going to the line for, I believe, his third or fourth set of free throws. And if I can see right, it looks like another sophomore is looking to check into the game. His name is Eric Liss, one of my good friends, really smart kid, goes to St. Pat's, went to St. Celestine for grade school. He's the tallest kid in our program, 6'7". And he's coming off another victory from the sophomores.
Yeah, the kid's a monster walking around the hallways, so much taller than everyone.
They call him the Big E, and they don't do that for any reason other than that he's 6'7". Io made the first.
You can just tell Io's going to be a big part of this program, especially with his size. Once he starts getting better in the post, he's going to be a hell of a player.
And not to mention that he's just a junior.
Yeah.
As Io will check out, and Eric Liss will come on in. Eric Liss wears number 35. And now it's a very young team in there. Two sophomores, a freshman, and two juniors. And that floater's good for the Aussies. Is there two? There's 2 minutes left as the Shamrocks lead 52-27. Marcus dribbling around, gets it to Jack on the edge. There's Eric in the middle setting a pick for Marcus Wright. Shoots the three, no good. Eric just barely missed the rebound.
Ooh.
And Marcus will get it back, but they'll call a whistle. Either a kicked ball or they might call a foul there as Xavier checks in for
Marcus. Yeah, it looks like they're going to call a kicked ball on that. He just kind of stuck his foot out, dribbled it right into it.
As Xavier checks into the game for Marcus, Marcus put on a pretty good game considering he's only a freshman.
Yeah, it shows how much poise he has. Just he had that one foul as a charge, but he still made the shot. Could have been a block.
Mm-hmm.
Thought it shows his extreme skill set, be able to take the foul and make the shot.
And it's now a 2-3 zone played by the Shamrocks. Blocked by Chris Lara, the sophomore, getting it done as Jack gets on the floor, and I believe it'll be Shamrock ball.
Yeah, it's one of the great things coming off the bench. You bring a lot of energy. See between them two, Chris Lara with the block, with the big block, Jack McLaughlin getting on the floor, getting the ball.
Now Xavier will show off some of his smooth moves as he heads towards the top of the key. Almost travels there, keeps the foot down and gives it to Chris Lara, to Jack, over to Mike on top, gives it back to Chris Lara as Eric's down low on the baseline. Xavier's dribbling around, gives it to Jack. Jack in the corner to Eric off his hands. Off his hands and out of bounds, it'll be the Aussie ball. Aussie ball with about a minute left as they are down 25.
Kind of would like to see Jack just shoot that. Seemed like he had an open shot at the top.
Now they're right back in man-to-man, it looks like, as he'll drive right in, no good. Rebound by Mike Killian to Xavier Pinson. Slow things down with about half a minute left in the game. And that'll be Jack heading right in with the good moves, unable to get the shot to go, however.
Yeah, nice aggressive play. Looked good.
Mm-hmm. And that'll be a foul, I believe, called on... let's see, Xavier Pinson, yep, his second, team's eighth, as they are now in the bonus.
Yeah, the second time that, I think it's number 10 for Australia, did that behind-the-back move.
And I believe the second time he was fouled when he tried to do it.
Yeah.
And that free throw will be good.
Kind of wonder why he's hasn't been as aggressive, and it seems like no one in Australia has really been aggressive trying to drive to the hoop.
They might owe that to some of the fatigue that they, considering they played yesterday. And we'd also like to give a little bit of a shout-out to the seniors that checked in, Dylan Keeneland, Cole Cairns, Ryan Gillespie, and Daniel Neeson.
Long pass,
and there's Eric Liss. Gets his first bucket on the varsity level. Attaboy, Eric.
Great court vision by Xavier, seeing him wide open in the way on the other side. Nice
that
pass.
That shot is no good. And the rebound is to Chris Lara to Xavier. And Jack will get a layup to good. 56-29.
Looks like Jack almost wanted to dunk that. We saw him dunk it in the dunk contest for Meet the Shamrocks.
And
definitely
that
has
is
ability.
No good. 4 seconds remain. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. 1. Shamrocks win. Fire up the fight song. The Shamrocks won another battle.
Yeah, great game all around for St. Pat's. Really dominated the whole tempo. Controlled the floor. Everything looked good.
As they go through the handshake, I'd like to say that this is our last broadcast before Christmas and the New Year, so we'd like to wish you all a happy New Year and a Merry Christmas. MVP, I'm going to do co-MVP. I'm going to give Jalen and Keyshawn the honors. They both put up 11 points, a couple rebounds, a couple assists, great defense, and they provided some fire behind this team's victory.
Yeah, they came out here with a lot of energy, hit their shots from three. That was big. Nice aggressive plays on both sides, both of them.
Do you have the same MVP award?
I'd also like to give Io a big MVP award. Mm. Go out there, a lot of size for Australia, still getting a lot of rebounds.
And it looks like the official scores for Jalen and Keyshawn. Jalen had 12 and Keyshawn had 18 points. And thanks for joining us here at Curling Court. The final score was Shamrocks 56-29 of the Aussie Basketball Travelers. Thanks to Coach O.C. for his halftime interview. We'd like to express our gratitude to some of the people behind the scenes that have helped to make this broadcast work and this broadcast possible. My brother Michael Pasquale, class of 2018, as a video and audio coordinator, and Joey Osterreich, freshman, only freshman on our team, as a camera operator. Without these guys, we would not have been able to put on such an excellent broadcast as we always do. And we'd like to express extreme gratitude to Coach Doyle, the guy who makes this possible, our producer and director. I'm Anthony Pasquale, class of 2018.
And I'm Nathan Zions, class of 2019.
Join us again on Tuesday, January 5th, 2016, as we take on St. Ignatius here at Curlin Court. We'll be on Ustream TV at 7. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at SPHS Webcast or drop us a line at SPHSWebcast@stpatrick.org. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We'll see you next time. Rock on.